perfect. Set it the wrong way. I should have taken off. It's this thing right here. See? So that's it. Do what I just did right there. That's the thing. What I need to remove is these two bolts right here. Oh, and obviously be careful if you can spin that shit out. Okay, so there's gonna be a real peasant fucking fix. It doesn't really make sense to remove those two bolts right there.
So there we just drop a washer basically.
I gotta go on the floor and I gotta fucking see where it is. So yeah, angle that. See, there's, it's completely unnecessary what I just did right there, that part. To get there, it's time to remove these two bolts. That's when this thing slides. Because it's technically not that. It's not that bad. Just give me a second. Look for something, might just be right there. Perfect. So we got there. We could put this thing back.
Always good to remember at the fucking place went back into police work. Like that. To do it at the moment. It doesn't really change anything. And that's it.
Now get to the next part, which is bolting this fucking thing. 21 bolt. 21.
This one was, one of those Allen bolts. You figure it out. Question is, do I want to do it with a gun or do I want to do it by hand?
I think we're gonna do it with the gun.
That's not right, but it was a gun. Obviously, as soon as you fucking let go of this thing, there's these fucking stupid little guide pins right there. That shit is gonna fall. So you gotta have the bad boy ready. Bro, easy. Didn't really bolt them that hard last time. This is where the pain in the balls begin. As soon as you release these fucking guide pins right here, this thing is just gonna drop. See? Oh, what we should have paid attention to was this little. But this you don't even have to worry. I think this thing bends like this and then slides the fuck out, right? I see, trying to slide the screw back. And there's this thing that by cultural means is just not gonna function properly. And this is most likely gonna break. Also, you gotta be careful with this, because that's also gonna bend. So if you're doing this, most likely, I would recommend
block to you guys.
So yeah, we're at the point. We removed this bad boy. We removed the 221 bolts. Like I said, there's these stupid little washers here.
Make sure that you put this properly.
Oh shit, my bad.
But those people find a wall, man, a wall.
See, look, last time that I did this motherfucking thing, right, that's what happens. I didn't capture the concept of it properly yet.
Right.
I ripped that bitch out. So that's that. Multiple ways that you could do this shit, right? So now we at that point. We at that level. Gotta take the hair in there too. Gotta make sure you remove that shit. Type of hair, bro. Whoa. Should have cooked the bearings. So yeah, we could obviously see that it's not parallel. I didn't think about that concept, right? I didn't think a lot about a lot of things. So another good point to remember is this bitch goes on one side of the fucking of the bracket right there. This bitch has back right here. Hold on, this right here, that one right there. Okay, that's that. See this thing? That goes first. Remember that. Or you fuck up and do something stupid. So now we did. We just arrived. Shit, but that thing seems like it's that. It seems like it's that. This is another step too. Yes, I mean, you could do it with a fucking air. You could do it with an electric ratchet and, you know, fucking suck it. I'm just doing it monkey style, I don't know why. I could be all high tech, right? Does that make so much noise? Too much. You know, the screws and the tires are all good. But this shit is all easy. There's no cons to it. So you ain't able to do it. So yeah, obviously. These are the little bolts. Right there. these discs from the fucking factory, they're fucking garbage. But as for what I can see, you could pretty much install any high performance mountain bike or shit. Yeah, any high performance mountain bike brakes with the rig are perfectly fine. I've seen a couple cool ones. There's different color ones. So I mean, you could take your pick. Just make sure that the diameter of the bolts is proper. But I mean, you're not gonna get too lost. It's pretty universal. It, make sure you put your bolts in the right spot. I mean, this is just again, pretty much. That's it. And this bitch is like fucking warped. So it's pretty much shit. Whatever. These ones you could fucking always fix them, obviously. There's always a way. If there's a will, there's a way, right? So you can always fix those bitches if you want. Just go get pero miren el otro tipo tiene long, ¿no? Long.
Por eso, o sea, ¿qué quiere decir? Que no es long, no es largo como debe quedar. Debe quedar es como donde lo están, como donde lo están,
okay.
Como donde lo están poniendo.
Pues así está bien.
Mire, como aquí es como debería quedar, chop. Si se chop, o sea que uno no puede quedar así, papá, no puede quedar así.
No.
No puede quedar, uno no puede quedar torcido.
No.
Ni tampoco puede quedar así. La posición correcta es esa, que esté así. Es como me veo el codo y es así, papá, mira, ¿verdad? Y no podía quedar tan cortica, tampoco podía quedar que yo quedé así, torcido con la mano así, estirada, no podía quedar, creo que la posición es esa.
¿Sí?
Aquí. Yo no sé qué quiero, lo que proper es como tener que la pieza aceptable.
Sí.
¿Ah? ¿Oh? ¿La desarmaste?
Sí, pero pues tengo que arreglar la llanta, está toda deforme.
Ok.
Y pues lo estoy grabando.
¿Ah?
Y pues lo estoy grabando.
Aquí está tremendo el camelloso.
¿Ah?
Tremendo, papá. Qué bueno ese mecánico, hijo.
Seguro.
Saber uno hacer algo, porque yo de barato eso, papel me pongo al malo y mínimo me queda faltando la...
Pero lo que pasa es que cuando te empiezan a salir las cosas mal, te frustras. Entonces eso es lo que, ese es el truco. Pues tú no has visto por qué siempre los mecánicos siempre fuman marihuana. Porque papá, cuando tú te empiezan a agitarte, es cuando empiezan a salir las cosas mal.
¿Ahí solo se tranquiliza?
Sí. ¿Seguro? Ok, papá. Alright, let's do this. So now we're gonna pull out the hat tag. We're gonna do it out. But first, we're gonna do it with the match.
Uh-huh.
Y porque mire, si ¿sí ve? ¿Sí ve? Aquí se ve que está, miren, aquí, ¿sí ve? La está centrada. Oh, shit.
¿Tú la puedes centrar?
¿Ah?
¿Puedo la centrar? Que mi papito ya casi se siente capacitado de montarla.
¿Ah?
¿Tú ya te sientes casi capacitado de montarla?
Seguro.
¿Sí?
Sí, sí. Sin problema.
Para que nos llevemos en el carro y para observarte.
Seguro, seguro.
Para un espacio grande, que hay mucho espacio grande donde ir.
Inclusive nomás
allá en Walmart, en donde vamos a marcar.
Sí, en el parqueadero o en el del shopping mall,
ese
es donde quiero ir.
Lo montamos en el carro y yo voy contigo para observarte, papá. No para montar,
no para montar con esta pierna, seguro que no. No, pues es un juguete, papá.
Thank you.
Sorry.
Bam, right here. Not that.
This is the other stuff that's important. It's taking all the air off this thing. See, basically I have no air. See how dangerous that shit is? No air. And then they give you this little BS thing.
So let's get to it, man.
Left off somewhere here. Attention to the bolts. Don't lose the fucking bolts. There's another bitch has bolts to put on too. Don't lose bolts. Make sure you pay attention what you're doing. It's very easy to pinch the fucking stupid tube, and that's gonna cause you to have a potential fatal accident. This is not a joke. This shit could kill you. Real easy too. Well, it's not one of them little bullshit scooters. thing is fast and is deadly. Basically, your wheelhousing. And this right here would be basically your wheel. So that's it. Like I said before, it's very easy to get it out of place. I think the last time was the mistake that I did is that they used the older tubes instead of putting new tubes. So this thing obviously must have got punched or somewhere. See? Where? But I don't care. Another thing, these fucking wheels are directional, so you gotta pay attention to the direction of the wheel. I know, because quite sometimes it's really That's why you always gotta make sure you carefully play this fucking thing. This is right there, so we're gonna go in that direction. So we know there's a lot. Now we're gonna slide in the tube tools. These are the new tube tools. So it's good to inflate them a little bit. I think maybe that's why they gave you that bullshit fucking pump that came in there. Rusty as fuck. So now this is gonna be the tutorials. It's always good to air it out just a little bit. Not too much. Remember to pay attention where the fucking thing's gonna slide in. Slides on the right. It's always on the valve. It's like an imprint right here. Right there. So you see? Here. See this little hole right there? That's where the valve goes. Basically, I gotta put it and remember the direction of this ship is in this direction. So basically, the valve, right? This thing. It's gonna have to point here. It's gonna be a little tricky. You know, it's gonna take a little working. It'll be easy, but getting this right is
one of the most important steps in lining up the freaking team.
Bam, bam. Look at that. Can't get better than that. Basically, because the other one goes slow. So,
wait a minute, give me a second. Basically, that's the most important thing to fucking slide right back in. Just getting it from this surface.
All right, we back at it. We back at it. Something, something, yeah, we back at it. All right, man.
Twist. Back at it. Set. Pulling that thing out of there. It's amongst the most important things to do. You gotta make sure that that valve comes out nicely. See, it's difficult. Because it wants to pop out. It wants to pop out as much as it wants to come back inside. But it can't go back inside. One dimension. Getting back. It's gonna be.
Especially putting it back on, actually, it's quite difficult too, as well.
You can fucking make sure it's in, right? And this time, I gotta make sure that this thing is balanced.